Hey, welcome to the Creek Crest Community Center. Let me just finish this paragraph. Okay, what's up?
Hi, my daughter just participated in a track and field competition. We're here to take up her ribbon.
Yep, I've got those.
Great, this is her.
Okay, I figured.
Mommy, can I buy something from the vending machine?
We're having a melt of fish later. Tuesday's Tuesday.
I'm just gonna look, okay?
And what event did your daughter compete in?
Shot put and hurdles, but she didn't place in that. She knocked over two other girls and also a boy who was not competing.
And what place did she get?
She got sixth.
Okay. Here you go.
I'm sorry, not to be a bother.
Sorry, let me just finish this sentence. Okay, hi. Oh, it's you again. It's a sixth place ribbon.
This is a participant ribbon.
Well, we ran out of sixth place ribbons.
That is absolutely unacceptable.
Mommy, can I have a dollar coin?
The sixth place ribbons are the same color as the participant ribbons.
So my daughter got sixth place.
Well, she was also a participant.
Ribbons are always awarded to the people who got the highest rank. You don't get a third place winner or a fourth place medal.
But they don't make fourth place medals.
Can I just please have a sixth place ribbon now?
Look, lady, what's the big deal with parkour and sports? What's so important about a sixth place ribbon?
Madam, do you know what they say about parkour?
Something about chivalry being dead.
The vending machine is empty.
My daughter here, she's gonna live to be 150, 200 years or more. That's what the scientists said.
Yeah, so?
So, it's gullible fool to believe that everything's gonna be hunky-dory once people are living to be as old as tortoises. You think that with all the memories bumbling around in my daughter's destiny brain, she's gonna remember that she won sixth place in a shot put competition when she was seven?
Will she care?
Excuse me, she will care! From her tattered scrapbook, the remains of a sixth place ribbon, ravaged by alien splooge juice. Planetary defense force, she will remember.
Wait, I'm sorry, I don't. Maybe
she won't make it past the movie. Maybe her mind is failing her. We've got a failing history of dementia here.
The soda pop machine is empty too. All of the soda pop, it's gone.
One day she finds a green ribbon. She squints, reads the faded gold lettering, participant. What is this woman, my daughter? When she is utterly lost and all she knows is that she wasn't even good enough to place, to rank in a shot put competition?
Wait, you think your daughter is gonna get dementia and this is gonna be her biggest problem?
Maybe she'll be a cyborg. Maybe as more and more of her dying organic corpse gets replaced by cyborgic metal parts. She'll reach for the ribbon.
Her last
message. She'll cry. One single final carbon based tear.
Tears are water based.
Just arguing with a woman makes you happy!
Okay, look! Why are you so obsessed with your daughter's demise? She's like 7 years old. She'll live for 80, 90 years if she doesn't smoke.
You're not a mother. It's not like you understand.
Oh, I'm a mother.
In what sense?
In the sense that I have a child. Damn it.
My hand got stuck. I put in the machine. I don't know why there's nothing in there, but now it's stuck.
Can we please just get
Let me just finish this word. Okay, oh, it's still Mortar Moore. What's your phone number?
Okay, 642-328-8888.
Okay, and what's your daughter's name?
Pam!